This is liquid nitrogen. Its temperature is minus 320 degrees Fahrenheit. Here's our flexible polymer, a rubber tube. Right now it's at room temperature. We're gonna put it in with the liquid nitrogen and see how it changes. The rubber is losing heat to the liquid nitrogen, causing that liquid nitrogen to boil. Hear that bubbling? Now when both things are about the same temperature, the bubbling stops. Let's see how the rubber is changed. The rubber tube is brittle and rigid.
By combining this boiling hot water with super cold liquid nitrogen, we can force these vastly different temperatures to rapidly mix. Add a little soap for some bubbly pizzazz. In 3, 2, 1. Liquid nitrogen and water are both boiling, but at vastly different temperatures. When the boiling liquid nitrogen touches soapy boiling water, the nitrogen rapidly expands into a gas, forming bubbles, some of which capture water vapor. When we pop the bubbles, we see some of that white water vapor actually escape.
When I put the balloons into the liquid nitrogen, the air molecules inside get colder and stop moving around as much. That means that all of the molecules in the liquid nitrogen push in on the balloons and cause them to get smaller. When I take the balloons back out of the liquid nitrogen, they'll start to get warmer, and those molecules inside will move more and push back up against the inside of the balloons. This will cause the balloons to re-inflate. Ooh.